All right, State University and the University of Dayton students started classes today. News Center 7's Kayla Cravel looks at how the colleges are navigating through a new semester here in the pandemic.
As August winds down, another semester at University of Dayton and Wright State University winds up.
The excitement on campus now is just amazing.
Wright State Dean of Students Chris Taylor said the university is determined to make this year a smooth one. Between the two schools, many of the COVID protocols are similar to what they were last year, like masks required while indoors. Outdoors, as you can see kids walking to class at UD, masks are not required. Prior to the start of classes, both universities offered vaccines to students during move-in. While they're not required at UD or WSU, Taylor says they could reconsider that if a vaccine is fully FDA approved.
I think we'll consider it certainly and look at, you know, not only what the state is telling us, but, you know, local public health and then, you know, what makes sense for campus.
Over the past couple of days, as students have been moving in here to the University of Dayton, the university has offered opportunities for students to get the vaccine. As of August 15th, though, a vast majority of those who are here are already vaccinated. 82% of employees here at UD have already gotten the vaccine, and 68% of students have been vaccinated as well.
And I'm not really nervous about that at this point. It's been like, what, a year and a half at this point, so I'm just kind of used to it.
University of Dayton freshman Paul Takarn said COVID is the last thing on his mind as he looks forward to having a regular freshman year here.
I want to try to join a running club, and then I always wanted to play soccer.
While school officials work to make it as normal as possible, they're looking for ways to do it safely. Here at Wright State, before moving into their dorms, all students were tested for COVID, and they'll continue to be tested throughout the semester.
I won't say that we have firmly established exactly how we're going to do that and how many people yet. You know, for us too, I think we have to see, you know, what our final enrollment count is going to be. So we'll kind of determine it based on that and do a percentage. With testing our incoming residential students, we sort of have a baseline, I guess I would say. You know, we're going to look at exposures and outbreaks, and then also our wastewater testing.
That wastewater testing could be key in preventing outbreaks here at Wright State.
If you have the virus, it sheds, you know, through wastewater. And, you know, based on certain levels of that, you can determine if something's going on, maybe even before people realize that, you know, they're sick.
Taylor said both students and staff are looking forward to once again holding events to welcome students back. In Dayton, Kayla Cravel, News Center 7.